I had a good friend that I played with a little bit. I didn't play with him all the time, but his name was Terry. They call him T.W. Williams. Terry had this little music store, and we'd go up there and jam and play and hang out. And there's a three-legged dog wearing a bandana, you know, laying on the floor. And if I ever decide that I want to slow down, if I had a store like Terry's, he kind of built the seed, planted the seed there for that. And I thought, what a cool way to do it. And still have it old-timey, you know, have it where, you know, we're not losing it. So that's what I tried to do. When I was in grade school, there was a lady came around once a month with a little pitch pipe, you know, and she'd hit this note, and everybody would sing, and you'd learn these classic songs like This Land Is Your Land, Buffalo Gal, Won't You Come Out Tonight, you know, and all these songs, you know, Eating Goober Peas, songs we grew up with, you know, I mean, that were part of the threads, you know, of the USA. And, you know, you go to schools now, and you sing some of those old songs to grade school kids, and they look at you like they've never heard them. And you take a couple generations like that, and nobody's left to know these songs, and you've lost a big part of your culture. You know, it was just, looking back, that's some of the best memories, you know, that I could think of. I mean, you have televisions and stuff raising kids now, and they're missing out on that kind of stuff, you know. You know, there's good kids out there. I ain't saying all the kids, you know, are bad or anything like that. I mean, you're going to come up with what you're exposed to, you know, and I just think they need to be exposed to some other things. You see this fiddle?
Mm-hmm.
This is Americana, kids. I mean, this card that came with it, this guy's name was Howard Heaven. He was age 16, and it says in 1913 to his beloved mother, he made this for her with his own hands, apologizing to her for all the trouble he had put her through raising him.
Wow.
16 years old, and I'm sure he's doing this from memory, from seeing a fiddle, and it's pretty cool, man. I mean, look at that fiddle. I mean, that's real Americana, you know?
That's amazing.
How many 16-year-old kids today are going to go to the trouble to do that much to build something like that for their mother, you know?
Not a lot.
You know, I get kids coming in here wanting to learn guitar, you know, and whatnot. And I tell you what, I think getting back on the kids today, what's this new thing called Guitar Hero? The game or whatever? You know what I'm talking about? I think in a way that has kind of brought people back to real guitar, because some of them now are saying, hey, you know, I want a little more. And they're picking up a real guitar and learning. So to me, that's a plus, you know. If we can get them to leave the video games alone that long, and pick up a real guitar. We've been cheated out of a lot of good musicians from stuff like that. But I want to keep this going. It's like a labor of love to keep the museum, because this cat and this cat and this kitty, they need to see places like this while they're still available. You know what I mean? And when one of them comes in here and appreciates this store, you know how that makes me feel? I feel like, hey, I've done my job.
What's the matter with the clothes I'm wearing? Can't you tell that your tie's too wide? Maybe I should buy some old tab collars. Welcome back to the age of jive. Where have you been hiding out lately, honey? You can't dress trashy till you spend a lot of money. Everybody's talking about the new sound. Funny, but it's still rock and roll to me. What's the matter with the car I'm driving? Can't you tell that it's out of style? Should I get a set of white wall tires? Are you gonna cruise the miracle mile? Nowadays you can't be too sentimental. Your best bet's true baby blue continental. Hot funk, cool punk, even if it's old junk.